are doing is trying to explain kids about viscosity of water and how water reacts on pressure and things like that. So this is what is in science terms they call a non-Newtonian fluid. So basic definition is that it's a liquid, like you can see here, it flows. It's a liquid, but it'll become a solid when pressure is applied. So if I pick up a chunk of it, I can make a ball out of it, and I can keep playing with it, and it'll continue to remain a ball till I'm applying pressure. The moment I release it is when it's going to melt again. So a couple of experiments we've come up with. One is this plank of wood. It'll be very difficult to nail into this with a hammer because of the density. So it's very fluid. Whereas if I take another piece of wood and put it in this, I can easily hammer and nail it. That's the concept. Then it becomes difficult to take out. Okay, another couple of things is, for example, the ball is definitely going to sink inside. But the same ball will float for a fraction of a moment till it is solid and then it is slowly sinking. You want to try to take the ball out? Try and take it out. So the trick is the more the pressure that you're applying, the harder it gets to take it out. It's becoming a solid.
To make it slower.
Yeah, so you just need to pull it out slowly. Another thing you can do is we've connected the same mixture to a subwoofer just to see how it reacts.
You're melting the wire every time you go there.
Melting is coming.
That's happening just with the vibration. So another thing we've actually done is we made a full size version of that. So we've mixed about 75 kgs of water and water here. And basically the definition of you cannot walk on water is
practically walk on water. The faster you move, the pressure you keep applying, you're going to float.